Welcome back, everybody. Thanks for joining us here on CIB24.com for another edition of Sports Recap. As always, I'm your host, Travis Hedland, and today we're making predictions on the third round of the World Cup before taking a look at some free agents that have found themselves new homes for the 2014-15 season and breaking down the recent NBA and NHL drafts. Don't move now, ladies and gentlemen, because I promise we're just getting started. The World Cup is in full swing in Brazil as we prepare to kick off the third round this afternoon. So far in the tournament, we've seen elite-level plays, lucky bounces, jaw-dropping goals, and spectacular saves. But after beginning with 32 hopeful nations, the men have separated themselves from the boys, and we're down to our Elite Eight. In our first quarterfinal, we see host country Brazil taking on an impressive Colombia side that plays a very free and wide-open game that filters through their wings. Like Brazil's game against Chile, this is going to be a struggle. But when their backs are against the wall, I just don't think Colombia is going to have enough left in the tank to finish their South American rivals. And I predict Brazil to win 2-1. Europe has a close match of its own to look forward to, as France will take on third-place finishers in 2006 and 2010, Germany. Germany came into the tournament as many people's favorites to win, including my own. But without Mats Hummels in the lineup, there have been wide openings on the pitch for opposing teams to take advantage of. This game could really go either way, but at the end, I'm sticking with my prediction of Germany winning the entire thing and predicting a 2-1 win on penalty kicks. Next up, the Netherlands and Costa Rica. Oh, well, Costa Rica has had an impressive run so far, this match just isn't quite as hard to predict as the first two. Oscar Duarte will miss the game after receiving a red card against Greece, and the players that they will be fielding are just simply outmatched by the Dutch strikers. Expect the dribbling of Arjen Robben to shred them repeatedly and lead the Netherlands to a 3-0 win. Finally, we see Argentina taking on dark horse Belgium. Both teams are far from their best right now, but each has had moments of stellar play throughout the tournament. At the end of the day, Belgium lacks the defensive cover necessary to hold Argentina off forever, and one small crack in their armor could be all that's necessary. I predict Argentina to win 2-0. We're moving on to the NBA, where for the second consecutive year, we watched the Cleveland Cavaliers select a Canadian first overall at the draft. Small forward Andrew Wiggins, from the Toronto area and drafted out of Kansas, is excited to join the young nucleus in Cleveland that includes fellow Canucks Tristan Thompson and Anthony Bennett, whom he's played with in the past.
All right, so how do you plan on proving the critics wrong? How do you prove being the number one pick when you go into Cleveland?
Just going in and creating an impact off the bat, you know, just playing my game, have confidence in myself, you know, because I gotta believe in myself before anyone else can.
Jabari Parker of Duke went second overall to Milwaukee. Parker is extremely versatile and NBA ready, a great pick for the Bucks. And Philadelphia took a chance on Joel Embiid at number 3, taking the big man who slipped down from first overall after breaking his foot and requiring surgery. Rounding out the top 5, Aaron Gordon heads to Orlando, while Australian shooting guard Dante Exum will suit up for the Utah Jazz. The rookies aren't the only names in the headlines either, as free agency is now underway. The Toronto Raptors have re-signed Kyle Lowry to a 4-year deal worth $48 million. Now, the elite names like LeBron James, Chris Bosh, and Carmelo Anthony are all still available and meeting teams around the country to hear their pitches. But as of now, there's nothing official to report. Make sure that you check out this show's Facebook page and keep up with me on Twitter and stay informed on all of the news and updates. In the NHL, teams also went to the entry draft wishing well looking for reinforcements. While the crop of hockey prospects lacked the potential superstars of their NBA counterparts, several teams picked up players that will be able to contribute and have long and productive careers. Florida was first overall, and as expected, took talented and well-rounded two-way defenseman Aaron Ekblad. The Buffalo Sabres were next and took Sam Reinhart, a creative and intelligent forward with soft hands and incredible passing vision. Leon Draisaitl went third to Edmonton, while Samuel Bennett went to Calgary at number four, and Michael Dalcolli was taken fifth by the New York Islanders. NHL free agency is also underway, and several clubs have made major improvements to their lineups already. The Dallas Stars have won the Jason Spezza lottery, making a deal with Ottawa, who will now lose their captain for the second consecutive year. Dallas also added depth up front with skilled scorer Aleš Hemský. Jarome Iginla celebrated his birthday by signing a deal with the Colorado Avalanche, his third team in three seasons as he chases the Stanley Cup before his retirement. Colorado also acquired Daniel Briere, a small but fearless center with loads of experience and a scoring touch. Brad Richards is officially off Broadway, leaving the Rangers and heading to the Chicago Blackhawks, while Austrian winger Thomas Vanek will be making his way to Minnesota to join former Buffalo teammate Jason Pominville. Vanek also played his college hockey at the University of Minnesota. American Olympic goalie Ryan Miller will join the Vancouver Canucks on a three-year deal, while Dan Boyle has come to terms with the Rangers. Well, boys and girls, that's the end of another episode. Thanks for joining us here on CIB24.com, and please make sure that you like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter, and subscribe to both our YouTube and Daily Motion channels. Also, you can follow me personally on Twitter, at Travis Hedland, or like the show's Facebook page to keep up to date with the latest headlines throughout the week.